Willkommen zu einem DAF-Spezial. In den kommenden Minuten dreht sich alles um die Edelmetalle und den Ölpreis. Und ich freue mich, dass wir dazu eine Ikone auf diesem Gebiet im Gespräch haben, nämlich den Rohstoffexperten Jim Rogers. Hello and welcome, Mr. Rogers.
I'm delighted to be here, Marco. Nice to see you.
Thanks. You've always been traveling around the world, Mr. Rogers. Now you're in Singapore at the moment. Is it true that the demand for gold and silver is still high in Asia?
Well, yes. People are buying physical gold. There's no question about that. The Chinese are not buying as much as they did before, but there's certainly everybody in Asia, many people in Asia are still buying gold.
But if so, why then does the price for gold keep on dropping?
Well, there's more than just Chinese buying physical gold. There's lots of ways to buy and sell gold, and gold had a huge abnormal run for 12 years in a row. And it brought in a lot of people who are mystics, almost, who are true believers in gold. And until all of those people get washed out, I'm afraid gold cannot make a bottom. I own gold. I'm not selling my gold. I expect to buy more if the right time comes along. But there's still a lot of people who think that gold is holy and need to learn that markets can go down as well as up.
But the preconditions for gold cannot be better. After all, we see low interest rates and the printing machines for money are still extremely active. Why then don't investors run for gold?
Well, that's a very good question. And many investors are going for gold, as you said. You pointed out very clearly that they are. But as I said before, we have a lot of people who bought gold in the last 14 years. You know, gold has not had a proper correction for a long, long, long time. And until there's a proper correction, gold cannot make a bottom and start over.
And how much will the gold price drop further? What do you think?
Well, I have no idea. I'm not very good at market timing. I'm a terrible short-term trader. I can tell you that gold has not been down 50% in many years, and that is not normal. Most things go down 50% every 3 or 4 years, just the way markets work. If gold were to go down 50%, that would be $960 per ounce. If it goes to that, I hope I'm smart enough to buy a lot more.
The gold price is not the only one that drops. Oil, industrial metals, and soft commodities are all under pressure. Is this the end of the commodities super cycle?
Well, not in my view. As you may remember, with stocks, when stocks went up between 1982 and 2000, there were many times when stocks had big corrections. 1987, stocks went down 40 to 80%. 1989, 1990, 1994, 1998, 1997. There were many times when stocks had big corrections, scared a lot of people, and they thought the bull market was over. In my view, that's what's happening. I don't see enough permanent supply coming on stream in most commodities to end the bull market.
But why is there no rising demand for industrial metals? After all, the economy is thriving, and even if China has got some problems, as they say, still a growth rate of 7% is not bad at all, I guess.
Well, there has been rising demand for industrial metals. There's been rising supply as well. Many people went out and opened lots of new supply. They spent billions of dollars opening mines or expanding mines. That supply is now being worked off.
Let's talk about oil. What about oil? Is it the same, or is the fracking miracle in the USA responsible for the downfall of prices?
Well, the fracking miracle, as you put it, has certainly brought a lot of new supply on stream. America's production has gone up a lot in the last few years. Whether that's long-term or not is doubtful. I certainly don't see it as being. These are very short-lived wells. But when they all come on and everybody rushes in at the same time, you get a lot of new supply. And that has been a glut on the market. At the same time, as you know, Marco, nearly all other wells or all other fields in the world are in decline. The North Sea, Alaska, Middle East, everybody in Mexico, everybody else has declined, and Russia, everybody else has declining reserves. So you've had this gusher, which is offsetting the decline, but I doubt that the gusher is going to last much longer. We certainly know that the decline is going to continue.
But what do you think? Is there a bright future for this technology?
For fracking? Oh, I'm sure it's going to get better. Whatever, there's money to be made. Smart people start figuring out ways to make the money. And they improve the technology, they improve the drilling. So certainly, that's going to happen. But we still have the problem, Marco, that these wells don't have very long lives. At first, they produce a lot, but then the production goes down very quickly. Now, if you have a lot of wells come on in a short period, of course, the supply goes up. But we're learning that these wells decline very quickly, and you're already seeing that many people are suffering because the prices are not high, and there's a lot of debt. A lot of these people rushed out, took on huge debt because they were so excited. Now they're having to pay the price.
And also, taking into consideration that prices are low for crude oil, some companies might have problems financing this fracking projects?
There's no question that many of the companies which are in the fracking business rushed out and borrowed lots and lots of money. They became so excited about the initial results. And now many of those companies are running into problems. We're going to have some bankruptcies, I'm sure, and the production will level off again. As I say, these are short-term, short-lived wells. They don't have deep, deep, deep pockets like some in the Middle East and other places.
Let's come back to the oil. Some experts now say that the oil price will stay low in the long run. Do you think this is right?
No, in the long run, as I said before, we have the problem that nearly all major fields in the world have declining reserves. There is no major oil field that's been discovered in the last 40 years that's where the reserves are going up. Everybody's reserves are going down, except for the fracking. Of course, the fracking still is showing bigger reserves. So no, the price of oil, the surprise will be how high the price of oil goes eventually and how high it stays.
Now, a completely different question. How long will we go on calculating the prices of commodities in US dollar? After all, Asia is the main buyer concerning most commodities and has been for quite some time. What do you think?
Well, more and more people are moving away from the US dollar or trying to figure out ways to move away from the US dollar. You know, Brazil, China, Russia, many people want to find something to compete with the US dollar. And that process is beginning. We already have more and more people moving away from the dollar for trade and for reserves. How long? Oh, I don't know. It takes a long time. You know, there's even the renminbi, which might replace the dollar someday, is not convertible now, Marco. So it's absurd to talk about the renminbi until it becomes convertible and people get used to it. So we're going to use the dollar for longer than we should. That's because there's no alternative. But people are working for alternatives now. 10 years from now, I doubt if people will be trading most things in US dollars anymore.
So you don't believe that our world still needs a world reserve currency like the US dollar?
We need a reserve currency. We always have had something to keep our reserves in, something for trade. There's nothing else right now except the US dollar. But other things are beginning to rise. The renminbi is beginning to rise and other things.
Jim Rogers, then thank you for your time for the interview. We appreciate it.
Marco, it's always my pleasure. Thank you.
Thanks. Und damit sind wir wieder am Ende dieses DRF-Interviews. Ich hoffe, Sie haben einiges Spannendes mitnehmen können von der Legende von Jim Rogers, was er uns damit auf den Weg gegeben hat. Danke fürs Zuschauen und bis zum nächsten Mal.